गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज द पार्ट टू ऑफ आवर चैप्टर नंबर 9, लिविंग ऑर्गेनिजम्स कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स एंड हैबिटेट्स। फर्स्ट वीडियो वॉज ओनली ऑफ इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ दिस चैप्टर। नाउ वी शैल गो थ्रू द चैप्टर। यू हैव सीन दैट देर आर different organisms, right, that is living creatures, living organisms around you. There are different kind of living organisms in different regions. Supposingly, if we are talking about forest, then there are wild animals, different trees. If we are talking about a coastal region, then the trees, there are different, there are aquatic animal inside the water. If we are talking about a desert region, then there are camels, right? The plants there are also different. Means there are different kind of animals, birds, trees in different regions. अगर आप घर से बाहर भी निकल के देखेंगे, you will find many types of creatures. So organisms and surroundings where they live. There are different kinds of living organisms that were present in different locations. The desert had camels, the mountains had goats and yaks, right? And also some other creatures. Now crabs on the beach and such a variety of fish in the sea. And there are also some creatures like ant, spider, which are present in almost all those locations. The kinds of plants also are different from each other in different regions. So we shall go through activity 1 to understand it more. Let us start with the forest. Think of all the plants, animals and objects that can be found there. You can list out the things, plants, animals, also the objects which are found in a forest. List them in the column 1 of table 9.1. Okay. You can also consult interesting books. You can ask your parents, your friends to make a list of this. Try and include many plants, animals and objects, big and small. Similarly, in mountains, in the desert, in the sea, what all kinds of animals, plants you can find, you can list it out in the table 9.1 given. Okay. This is the homework. You have to. So this is the homework. You have to list this here only in the textbook itself. Okay. Next one. Habitat and adaptation. What is habitat? What is adaptation? What do you find from the plants and animals which you have listed in activity 1? Did you find a large variety? Yes, of course you have found a large variety. In sea, plants and animals are surrounded by saline water, that is salty water. So most of them use the air dissolved in water. And opposite in desert, there is very little water available in desert. It is a hot daytime and a very cold night. डेजर्ट है वहाँ गर्मी भी बहुत ज़्यादा होती है, ठंडी भी बहुत ज़्यादा होती है. सो इन द डे टाइम इट इज़ वेरी हॉट एंड एट द नाइट टाइम इट इज़ वेरी कोल्ड, राइट. सो द एनिमल्स एंड प्लांट्स ऑफ द डेजर्ट दे कैन लीव ऑन द डेजर्ट सॉइल एंड ब्रेथ फ्रॉम देयर सराउंडिंग्स. व्हाइल द प्लांट्स एंड एनिमल्स इन द सी दे कैन live in the salty water, right. In the sea the water is salty and they can live in that water. And if you are talking about a desert, then there is very little water, a very hot day, a very cold night. So वहाँ पे रहने वाले जो plants हैं, जो animals हैं, वो उस हिसाब से बने होते हैं कि वो लोग ऐसी सिचुएशन में भी सर्वाइव कर सकते हैं, ठीक है ना. अगर डेजर्ट में उगने वाले प्लांट जैसे कैक्टस, उसको आप पानी में डालोगे तो वो नहीं रह पाएगा, बिकॉज उसके पास वो कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स नहीं है, वो कैपेबिलिटी नहीं है कि इट कैन सर्वाइव इन वाटर. इट कैन लिव इन डेजर्ट ओनली प्रॉपरली, ठीक है ना. जैसे डेजर्ट एनिमल कैमल, द शिप ऑफ द डेजर्ट यू कैन से. कैमल है वो जितनी आसानी से डेजर्ट पे चल सकता है, दौड़ सकता है, इट कैनॉट गो ऑन अ माउंटेन. आपको डेजर्ट में जाना है तो यू कैन यूज शिप. इफ यू वॉन्ट टू गो इन अ माउंटेन हिली रीजन, देन कैमल इज नॉट यूज. सो कैमल इज मेड फॉर डेजर्ट, क्योंकि वही उसका हैबिटेट है और उसके जो फीचर्स है, जो कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स है, इट हेल्प देम टू सर्वाइव एंड लिव वेरी प्रॉपरली इन देयर सराउंडिंग्स. ओके, सिमिलरली लाइक फिश, इट कैन लिव इन वाटर ओनली, इट कैनॉट कम एंड रेस्पायर out of the water. So हमने देखा था last chapter में fish की streamline body होती है, how does it move, right? उसकी जो fins होते हैं that help them to swim. जमीन पे कैसे चलेगी, नहीं चल सकती, सांस भी नहीं ले सकती, चल भी नहीं सकती, right? Thus, like a camel cannot survive inside the water, right? So the place where a living organism live can survive is called its habitat. Okay, you can underline this very well. Here it is, the place where living organisms live is called habitat. Habitat means a dwelling, a place of home. अपना घर जिसे आप बोल सकते हैं, जहाँ रह सकते हैं, that is called habitat. Okay, what does it provide? It provides food, water, air, shelter and other needs to organisms. This is called habitat. Several kinds of plants and animals live in the same habitat, right? एक जैसे habitat में बहुत सारे plants और animals होते हैं. Now the plants and animals that live on land, they are said to live in terrestrial habitats. We have seen that the organisms which can live on land are called terrestrials. So, which are living on land, they are saying to be having terrestrial habitats. Examples of terrestrial habitats are forest, deserts, coastal and mountain regions. These are all the examples of terrestrial habitats, right? Okay. Now the homework is, you have to read page number 82, that is activity 2, and activity 3, that is your homework. Read it once and we will continue it in the next video. Thank you.